Hi guys, Miss Kate here. Hope you guys had a good week and are still doing well and staying healthy during this crazy time. So this week I have an activity for you, and it is all about computer coding. So computer coding, what it is a set of instructions that a computer reads. So every time you tap on your tablet, text a friend, play a video game, or even submit your schoolwork, you are giving your device an instruction. And when you give it that instruction, it has to be able to read it. Now computers, they don't speak the same language as us. So what they have to do is they have to speak and communicate through a special code. And the computer code translates into what you're telling the computer to do. So today what we're gonna talk about is a code called binary code. Binary code is a common language that computers use to follow instructions. Now this code is like a secret language, but it's only made up of the numbers 1 and 0. So with that message or instructions that you give in a computer, it is translated into a sequence of only 1 and 0s. So think of it as kind of like a top secret, like cryptic language or something that a computer speaks through. So every time that you like type in a number or tap the screen, it is actually giving the computer a code made up of only 1 and 0s. So today we're gonna make some binary code bracelets. And in the packet, you were given 2 instructional keys. And with these keys, they're gonna be super helpful, and they're gonna be the kind of translators for you for whatever number or letter that you choose to make your bracelet out of. So let's get started. Alrighty guys, so starting off, I'm going to be making the bracelet that correlates to a birthday. So this is the one that was the step-by-step instructions in your packet as well. So starting off for step one, what you're going to do is you're going to write out your birthday in number format. So I gave the example in the packet for a birthday that is November 15th, 2014. And so the number format for that would be 11, which is November, 15th, the date, and then 14 is the year. And so you might want to ask your parent or a sibling to check and make sure if you're not really sure how that works, but it works like January would be 1, February would be 2, and so on for the months. And then the last just kind of correlate with the regular number. So what you're going to do now is with each one of those numbers that you have written down, so 11, 15, 14, that is what you're going to be making your bracelet out of. So first, I'm going to look at 11 on your code here, right here, your code key. 11 is 1011. And so I have my beads over here. And so I'm decided that my blue beads are going to be my ones, and my yellow beads are going to be my spaces, and my orange beads are going to be my zeros. So starting off, it is 1011. So my blue bees, which is my 1. So I'm going to do 1011. So there is my 11 right there. So right there, there's my 11. And so what you're going to do is you can put your space, because we don't want all of our numbers to slide together. So there's my space, which is my yellow bead. And then the next number is 15, and that one's easy because it is just 4 ones. So I'm going to take 4 blue beads. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there is my 15. So now I'm going to add another space. And next we're going to do the 14. So I go back to my key, and it is 3 ones and 1 0. So perfect amount of blue beads left. So yeah, 3 ones and 1 0. Alrighty, and if you wanna put spaces on the end pieces, you can too. I'm just gonna leave mine kinda like that. But there it is, that's my pattern I have laid out for my birthday that I have chosen, which is November 15th of 2014. So if you have that birthday, this is what yours would look like. So go ahead and take the next couple minutes and translate your birthday there for you into your beads. And I'm gonna show you another option of what you can do with the first letter of your name. Alrighty guys, so now I'm gonna show you how you can make your bracelet with, instead of doing your birthday, you can do the first letter of your name. So what I have here is the printed out key of the letters in correlation to what it would be in kind of a binary code. So the black squares represents the ones and the white squares represent the zeros. But you're just gonna choose whatever color you want of your beads to represent the black squares and whatever color bead you want to represent the white squares. So for my bracelet, what I'm gonna be doing is I'm going to be using my pink beads to represent the black squares or the ones, and my orange beads to represent the white squares or the zeros. And then you also need your spacer beads again, which I'm going to be using as the yellow beads. So let's go ahead and look at the chart. Now my first name begins with a K. So what I'm gonna be doing is it is black, white, black, black, spacer bead, white, black, white, white. So now we gotta translate that into our beads. So I'm gonna be using pink, orange, whoops, pink, pink, and then a space, and then orange, whoops, pink, orange, orange. Alrighty. So that would be the letter K in binary code. Now binary code, it's made up of a lot more for the letters, a lot more ones and zeros. So that's why that's kind of a two space one compared to the numbers. So yeah, there you are. So once you have that, go ahead and string that onto your pipe cleaner. And then I will show you how you can close off your pipe cleaners and have it fit to your wrist, okay? Alrighty guys, so great job making those bracelets. I have those two right here. And so now I'm gonna show you how you can close them off and fit them around your wrist. You can either do this kind of out in the air, or if you wanna get someone to help you and place it around your wrist and then they can help twist it off for you. But all you're gonna do is you're gonna take the two ends of it and you're gonna cross them so they make an X. And then you're just gonna keep rolling the pipe cleaner over so it's twisting around itself, and then you'll do the same on the other side until you have it closed off and those ends are nicely tucked in and they're not poking you. There you go, you have your own pipe cleaner bracelet that has a secret message. And so now when people ask you, hey, what is your bracelet, is it just beads, you can be like, no, it's binary code for my birthday. So very cool. Another activity with this key is you can try to create a secret message to decrypt. So what I did is I just took some of the crayons from last week and I made the red crayon represent the black squares and the orange crayon the white squares, and then I took the yellow crayon and just do the dashes where the spaces are. So here I have my own little message for you, and I'm gonna see if maybe you can try to decrypt it for us. So use your chart over here and I will help you with the first letter. But see if you can try to figure out what my message is. I wrote it out here at the bottom. So let's look at the first letter here. Here we have, so the spaces is the spaces in between the letters, and the dashes is when it's end of a word. And it ends at an exclamation point. So the first one we have red, orange, red, orange, red, orange, orange, orange. So that's our first letter, okay? So let's go to our chart here. So red is black, so look for something that is red, orange. So these are all red, orange. So it looks like all of them begin with red, orange. And then our second letters is red, orange again. So it's not gonna be any of these ones in the first column or these ones, but it's gonna be from P to Z. So the letter we're looking at is from P to Z because it is red, orange, red, orange. And those are all red, orange, red, orange. And then for the second half of our letter, it is red, orange, orange, orange. So we're looking for a black square with three white squares. We know it's from P to Z because of the first column, but what would that be? That would be a W, right? So go ahead and you can write it here. Right here is a W, and it's our first letter too, so W. So go ahead and I'm gonna freeze this on the screen and see if you can decrypt the rest of our message, okay? And we'll come back in a couple minutes and I'll show you what it is. Alrighty, here is my message all decoded here for you. The message I wrote to you is wash your hands. So remember to be washing your hands during this crazy time. So now what you can do is you can make your own little message if you want to. You can make it to a sibling, a friend, and then give them the code here and see if they can decode the message you wrote to them. Alrighty guys, well I hope you have fun with today's STEAM lesson and I hope you have some cool bracelets and secret message to show for it. Another activity that you can do if you have this at home, if you have like anything like trail mix ingredients that you could use, such as like pretzels, marshmallows, or chocolate chips, you can even practice your binary code out in that and then you can have a whole snack when you're done. But yeah, so I hope that you can take this and use it as like a secret language with your friends and practice your binary code with it. And yeah, I hope you had fun with today's lesson and stay healthy and stay safe, and I will see you next week.